to be presenting the world premiere of a work by Juantio Vicente, a New Mexico-based composer that we commissioned, and we were actually set to premiere this last year, shortly in late March, as a matter of fact, of 2020, and through various delays, we're very happy to finally presenting the premiere today. So when we started speaking with Juantio about his music and about the piece he wanted to write for us, he mentioned a few influences and some music that he was listening to and considering and thinking about, and two of the pieces he specifically mentioned were these solo piano works, Debussy's Sunken Cathedral and Charles Ives' Three-Page Sonata. So I thought that those two pieces would make a nice little introductory set to the morning, and it's the only thing I want to mention about these two pieces, which for the most part require no introduction, is that I'll be playing Debussy and then the Ives, which is actually reverse chronological order. The Ives Three-Page Sonata being the older work by about 5 years. So, thank you for joining us this morning, and I hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Please welcome our poet this morning, Jessica Helen Lopez.
Soy Chicana, soy mestiza, soy poeta, soy madre. And you know, it's springtime now. Spring has sprung, and that makes me think of being in love. So this is a series of three love poems that I'm going to share with you today. I rode my bike here, y'all. And so this is actually a love poem for being outdoors, for loving nature, for loving riding bicycles, and just loving the earth as it is. So mountain bike. Trail, baby willies, and the river. I love you, and so I followed you into the wild, my bike chain squeaking, and I did not know what gear to stay in. The cranes were soft white, 10-watt halogen bulbs, skimming the shallow winter river, splendid scavengers of the wetland, gregarious birds of Alaska, Siberia too. I wanted to sound smart, and so I mused aloud, they must be eating grubs, and look, there are 13 of them. Together, they are called a dance. Herd of the sandhill longnecks, they are majestic party favors, silent but festive, festooned with a quiet, stolid beauty. You turned to me, and I saw the sun setting into your eyes, how alive you were. I should have been more excited than I was, but the gold glint of the Rio Grande hypnotized me, and I was unusually calm. When you kissed me, your lips were cold and wet, our clunky bike helmets headbutting one another, sounding a lovely, awkward, muted funk. I laughed, and the moment shifted on, as moments often do. I kept up with you, followed the winding trail perched atop my refurbished front-wheel shock-absorbent bike. I was not surprised at my agility, for I am young in the heart and in the thighs. I popped a tiny willy, emulating your grand mountain bike skills, and felt proud, as if I were your daughter or maybe a best friend. You rode into the wind, slicing it neatly with your lean body, black matte bike with all of its impressive gadgets. You pumped your legs and the chambers of your heart, exalting that thing we call life. You were as gorgeous as a gilded bell. The blood rushed to your brown cheeks, coloring you russet, cold wind-whipped nose, and the mouth hue of a clay jug. You were a benevolent and patient teacher, and my admiration of you was a new and wizened, glowing, growing respect. I knew then I would love you for always. The cranes kept at their eating, pecking mealy plants, grains, and miniature crustacean of prey, long-legged luminescent creatures overstaying their migration, a late February surprise. They became smaller and smaller in the distant past as we created miles between us and them. We thrust our childish, happy legs like pistons, the tread beneath us imprinting a lattice into the dirt, delicate like the fossil of an ancient fern or a sand-colored lace. The river told me that you loved me too, but I don't think you heard its gurgling secret. You rode ahead, turned a corner, cottonwood and dead tree, dark bark enveloping your shadowy shape, and I lost sight of you. For good 2 minutes or three, I lost sight of you. Breathlessly, I was alone, and it felt good and cold in my bones. I can't remember if I was sad. I trilled with the delicious thought that I could become lost, thick in the forest, the braided brush, home of horsetail, fragrant ash, salt grass, left behind, never to catch up with you. Always a few yards behind, lost like how I am used to, a comfortable, comforting aloneness. I was born into this world solo, and that is how I shall leave it, no matter. The cranes are etched into the gelatin, silver-plated photo of that day, and they always come back. Maybe they never left. Gracias, thank you. All right, so this one's an oldie but goodie. That first piece is kind of new, and the last piece I'll read is also new. But this one was written a few years back, and maybe it was just a rumination over what love could be. And so it's titled, I Would Love Like This If I Were You. If I were a man, I would be dashing. Not unlike the silver tip of sword and the black cloak of Zorro, I, the mustachioed lip of hero and swooning love. If I were a man, I'd whisper silvery minnows that darted like intimate whispers into your naked coiled ear of cupped flesh, silver flashes of true light. I'd waste away in your breath and sweet feminine sweat. I'd gulp your musk from a greedy goblet. I'd be the suicidal Romeo of your reverie. If I were a man, I would be the woman you always wanted me to be. The silence that only the trees can bring when there is no wind to speak of. I would cup you like a womb and be the barefoot male divinity, that of brute arm and dark hair, thick pelvis and broad waist, ripe in shoulder and indestructible Achilles. I would take my cloak and cover your nakedness, swashbuckle my way into your memory. I'd be the Bogart without the ego, Orson Welles without the selfishness. I would color your world with all of the creative energy that I could muster. If I were a man, I'd be debonair and strike your fancy, the Laurence Olivier of glittering desert and silk tents, yellow flapping yards of fabric curling around the breeze, curling around the dry sun that festoons your desolate sky. I would tiptoe around your clouds, offer my sinuous desire and motherly love. I would smooth the wrinkles from your sad coat. I am no Diego. I would paint no one but you, jealous and guarded of your russet form. If I were your man, I'd bow my lovely head like the soft brow of a velvety doe. I would surrender beneath the fern. Listen to me. Coo for you. Like a flock of doves would. Like the spent rain over summer mountains, I print 1,000 knives of poetry into your quintessence, sweep over the Mojave as rain does. I would sprout for you the unexpected green life from the parched, cracked lip of dirt. If I were a man, I would clasp you to me, save myself in a silver locket that breathes against your clavicle and lay like soft metal against the skin over your lungs, the copper taste of kisses beneath the tongue. I'd be your burnt penny. I would be your loika. I would be the heart and safe sword that held you like I would want to hold myself. If I were a man, I would be dashing, the Don Quixote of your afternoon poem, frail, skinny old man with the heart of a golden lion. I would trip over you like a windmill, paint you like a Spanish cubist, juxtapose your breasts against the oil paint of strange angle, the awkward beauty of shape and sharp line. Drink me like watermelon, ample flesh and emerald wine, the ruby fruit fashioned from the lovely garden of the age contented wife. Drink me like a garden. I will not elude you. I will toil within you. I will be dashing through and through.
Muchísimas gracias. Believe it or not, I wrote that piece right after a breakup, so there you go. this is my last piece, and it's, you know, it's still in exaltation of riding bicycles and being out there in the world. That's my theme lately. And so this is for a special friend. It's called Caballero Jando, aka Caballero Alejandro. Pretty brown bad boy and his hitch, hiking mud heavy and flit and flight and fancy, wheel drunk up a sacred mountain, dirt dizzy, levitating over the pockmarked sacred earth, tierra titan, flying over boulder, tiny and largesse, jaguar blessed. The sun is his temple. Cloud, pompous, rain, drizzled, whatever season, he two-steps the landscape, spitting into the wind, the cape-clad caballero be spitting into the wind, ocelot of the juggernaut, ziggurat, winding, winding, roads and blazing paths, passageway, pursuing the rubber tread, hugging the trail tight like holding a woman close, body, the sensual small soft of the lower back, carving lace and lattice into the ground, around, around, around those wills go, breathing life into his lung, revolution of 360 degrees, breeze, free, flee, pretty brown bad boy and his hitch, two-stepping itch, a Tejano wail into the wind of Caballero and his double-winged horse, Pegasus, chain, gears, brakes, carbon body, oil frame, banked corners and boosters, digging deep into the clay, silt, sand, sediment, forging his way, it is the ballad of the caballero, his cape, a red flag fluttering from his neck, ribbon unfurling, ephemeral and alive. Thank you so much, Cindy Chatter. Muchas gracias.
Hello, my name is Juantillo Vicente. I am a composer from Farmington, New Mexico, and I wrote this piece for Chatter called Melodrama. It is part of a series of pieces that I've entitled Divertimento. This piece is the fifth part in that series. I'm calling it a melodrama without words because I think of each movement as a sort of set piece in that highlights a particular instrument of the ensemble and forms a larger dramatic program. A divertimento has historically been regulated to light entertainment. In that spirit, the structure of this piece is all on the surface and more concerned with texture rather than any sort of underlying musical structure. Though at times the music may sound dense, that is only because I am aiming for a texture above anything. I wanted to write something sensuous and in the moment. The composers who most influenced me in this piece are Charles Ives, Toru Takemitsu, and Arnold Schoenberg. Schoenberg wrote a very famous melodrama called Pierre Lunaire, and I would certainly recommend that to your listeners. The titles of the movements and the instruments I attempted to highlight are as follows. One, The Clouds at Prayer with cello. Two, A Red Flock with clarinet. Three, Dreams Not Remembered with piano. Four, Snow Breeze with violin. Five, Twilight Fire with horn. Six, The River at 3 a.m. with percussion. And finally, seven, Rustling with flute. I'd like to thank Luke Gallitzin in particular for setting this all up, and for the rest of the ensemble for taking the time to learn my music. After spending time writing any particular piece, hearing it brought to life by talented musicians is a joy for me that is unparalleled.
We're so happy to finally be premiering Juantillo's piece. We were going to do this last year. When the pandemic hit, we had planned on doing it a week later, like March 20th, 2020. So here we are a year later, but we're really happy to play it for you.